Clay, the start of the new year also means the start of new laws for Minnesota. They cover everything from sick time to changes for landlords and tenants. CeCe Gaines is live at the Capitol to break down what went into effect just 6 hours ago. Good morning, CeCe.
Hey, good morning and happy new year. Yeah, like you mentioned, there's a lot of changes coming our way this new year, but we're going to break down some of the bigger changes that are happening. And first, we can start with firearm safety. If you take a look at your screen here. From having access to a firearm if they think they're a danger to themselves or others. Lawmakers say the courts and law enforcement will be a big part of the process before guns are actually confiscated. Now to health. There's a new earned safe and sick time law. Employers have to allow workers up to 48 hours of paid sick time a year. This is for anyone working over 80 hours a year. And tenants, you'll get more rights today, too. Some of the major changes include landlords have to keep their buildings at least 68 degrees from October to April. They must give at least 24 hours notice before entering a rental unit and 14 days written notice before filing evictions if rent hasn't been paid. Now, again, all of these go into effect today, and you can find a full list of new laws on our website. But coming up in 30 minutes, we're actually going to tell you about the lesser known laws that also go into effect today. Alicia.
All right, CeCe, thank you for that. And happy new year to you as well. We're talking about lawmakers going to be returning from holiday break later this month with a list of New Year's resolutions that they have to tackle. Migration at the southern border appears to have reached a new record. Ukraine and Israel are desperate for funding, and another government shutdown could be looming. Amy Kiley reports on what awaits the U.S. in 2024.
The U.S. is ringing in the new year with migration and funding concerns threatening to explode.
When you're talking about 10% of the budget to allocate for cities on this, that's unsustainable.
Preliminary government numbers show record migration at the southern border in December. Texas Governor Greg Abbott says his state can't handle the surge, so he's sending migrants north.
They're being told that they are in the city of Chicago, literally dropped off in the middle of nowhere. I find that to be inhumane and unconscionable.
Likely, we will see more people die as a result of the inability of governments to really address the humanitarian needs.
In Congress, both parties say they want to address the border crisis, but Republicans say it has to come first. That leaves Ukraine and Israel desperate for aid as they grapple with new casualties and destruction, some just hours into the new year.
I cannot come back to South Carolina and talk about giving aid to Ukraine and Israel if the border is still broken.
And that's not the only budgetary battle awaiting lawmakers after the holiday recess. The federal government is running on stopgap funding. Without a deal, it could shut down in about a month. I'm Amy Kiley reporting.
In just over 5 hours, all 13 members of Minneapolis' City Council will take the oath of office at City Hall. This new year, the council is working with a $1.8 billion budget that addresses everything from a pilot project to clearing sidewalks and climate change, as well as public safety. There's just 4 days left until the city closes the homeless encampment on Minneapolis' south side known as Camp Ninokasi. Now, the city said they've connected more than 100 people with shelters and now plan to close the camp Thursday. The city previously delayed its closure but says it's necessary because of ongoing safety issues, including a deadly shooting there that happened last month. This morning, motor vehicles, snowmobiles, and ATVs are now banned temporarily from traveling on a portion of Upper Red Lake. Those restrictions went into effect after several incidents involving fishermen getting stranded on broken ice. The latest happened Friday night around 5 when 122 people had to be rescued. The Beltrami County Sheriff's Office told us the people were fishing on the lake when a chunk of ice that they were on detached from the shore. Authorities say 4 fishermen fell into the lake before emergency responders arrived, but thankfully there were no injuries. And after a couple of hours, all the people had been brought back to shore. And the DNR is reminding people that no ice right now in the state is safe under these warm weather conditions that we've been seeing. But hopefully, as we get colder here the next couple of days, John, things will start to freeze up. Because as we saw some video, people were skiing on a lake in Wisconsin. Not bad.
I mean, I'm not a fan of it. It's crazy, but it is just time. We're going to have a short window here for winter, but it is going to show up. So people who love winter, January, probably early February is going to be your time, because we're going to be talking about here end of the weather. It is going to get colder. Chilly start today. It is going to be a quiet week ahead. One shot of cold air should lock up these lakes for good. Light snow is going to be possible this weekend. This weekend snow, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday all looks possible, but if there's going to be something major, it would come early next week, Monday or Tuesday. Again, that's pretty far out, but it does look more active as we get into the weekend. 5 degrees cooler right now than yesterday at this time. So temperatures in the 20s or teens, grab a coat. 23 degrees, cloudy skies. You have northwest winds at 7 miles per hour. At least visibility is good. We've had really some tough mornings, actually, surprisingly, over the past 5 days, just from a little snow, some refreezing. There's still some slick spots, but it's not too bad. 15 degrees right now in Bemidji, Upper Red Lake. People getting stranded out there and stuff. Obviously, we need some cold air to start showing up in northern Minnesota. Teens is going to help. I think we'll see single digits or below zero temperatures not too far away. Cloudy skies, always going to keep your temperature a little bit warmer than if it was clear. Clear skies are going to come in this afternoon. You can see Bismarck, Winnipeg, clear skies are definitely on the way. Here's what it looks like today. Sunshine in the afternoon, 30, 31 degrees for a high. And again, the sunshine is going to feel great. It should clear up the roads a little bit. All in all, very quiet start to 2024. Temperatures across the area, 30s or maybe upper 20s to the north, but still way too warm for winter to really settle in. That's going to change. First time all winter long through pretty much October. I can go all the way back through October since I've shown a graphic of forecasted below average temperatures. That is expected, well, not next week, but I think about 10 days from now really hits. And it's the question is how cold? We know it's going to be cold, but how cold? Are we talking 20 below or are we talking zero? I mean, it's going to get cold either way. This week, enjoy it. Nice and quiet. 31 on Wednesday, 30 on Thursday with some flurries on Friday.